In the previous sixth episode, we have learned the fivefold chitta vrittis. Also, we have learned that restraining the chitta vrittis would help us attain the state of yoga. And the state of yoga would help us see our true nature or swarupa. And then we have concluded the episode with a question. And the question was, how do we do this chitta vritti nirodha? In answer to this question, Sage Patanjali explains the ways to do chitta vritti nirodha, thus abhyasa vairagya abhyam tan nirodha. As usual, let us see the constituent words of this sutram, abhyasa vairagya abhyam and tan nirodha are the constituents of this sutram, among which abhyasa vairagya abhyam is a compound of abhyasa and vairagya, which are the means, and tan nirodha is a compound of tasya and nirodha, in which the word tasya refers to the chitta vrittis. Therefore, the sutram says that abhyasa and vairagya are the means to restrain the chitta vrittis. By abhyasa, the chitta vrittis or engagements or preoccupations of the mind through the senses are retracted or withdrawn from the sense objects, or simply say external cravings, and turned inward. And vairagya helps find the disadvantages or bad consequences or detrimental effects of indulging in the material or sensual enjoyments, as a result of which there arises aversion or dislike towards the material world or sensual enjoyments. The chitta vrittis or preoccupations of the mind through the senses have both positive as well as negative consequences. In other words, chitta vrittis bring good or beneficial as well as bad or detrimental effects. Here, with abhyasa, the door to discriminative knowledge is opened, and with vairagya, the sources of all negative or bad or detrimental conditions are controlled. Thus, chitta vritti nirodha is dependent on both these, namely opening of discriminative knowledge by abhyasa and closing of all detrimental sources of worldly experiences through vairagya. Now, let us see in a little detail descriptions on abhyasa and vairagya as provided by Sage Patanjali. And let us begin with abhyasa. Tatra sthitau yatnobhyasah. Tatra sthitau yatnah and abhyasah are the constituents of this sutram. Let us see the meaning of each of these words. The word tatra is a correlative term that refers to the current context of discussion on the means of chitta vritti nirodha, and the reference is made to both abhyasa and vairagya. Sthitau means to remain steadfast. It refers to the steadfast condition that we have discussed earlier as avasthanam, that we have learned in the sutram Tada Drashtu Swarupevasthanam in the fourth episode. It refers to the condition at which the senses are no more perceiving their objects. The intellect in whose hands mind is the rein to control the senses turns within and dwells in its own nature. And yatna means the effort a person takes to attain the steadfast condition. Please note that this yatna or effort is famously known as the ashtangas in the yoga philosophy, the eightfold practices. Thus, yama niyama asana pranayama pratyahara dharana dhyana samadhayoshtangani is the sutram that describes these eightfold practices. We will learn this in detail in the future episodes in the second chapter while dealing with this sutram. Now, let us continue the present discussion. So in short, Abhyasa is practice that includes certain internal as well as physical efforts to secure the mind steadily in its true nature after retracting it from its preoccupations through the senses. And the next sutram says how this practice can be well grounded. Satu dirghakala nairantarya satkarasevito dridhabhumi. Saha tu dirghakala nairantarya satkarasevitaha dridhabhumihi are the constituents of this sutram. The word saha refers to abhyasaha or practice. The word tu is a particle. In the current context, it's an emphatic particle that emphasizes what is going to be said about abhyasaha or practice. The word dirghakala nairantarya satkarasevitaha is a compound of dirghakala, nairantarya, satkara and asevitaha, in which the last word asevitaha is repeated along with the rest of the three words to complete the meaning. Thus, dirghakalam asevitaha, nairantaryena asevitaha and satkarena asevitaha. Asevitaha in the present context means something done with a mind of devotion and commitment. Dirghakalam means for a long period of time. So, dirghakalam asevitaha means done with or practiced with a mind of devotion and commitment for a long period of time. And nairantaryena means incessantly or without interruption. So, nairantaryena asevitaha means done with or practiced with a mind of devotion and commitment incessantly or without interruption. And satkarena means with great attention and reverence. Hence, satkarena asevitaha means done with or practiced with a mind of devotion and commitment with great attention and reverence. Dridhabhumihi means firm-footed or well-grounded. So, in short, Satu dirghakala nairandarya satkarasevito dridhabhumihi means that this practice becomes well-grounded when continued with reverent devotion and without interruption for a long period of time. Thus, among the two means of chitta vritti nirodha, we have learned what is abhyasa. The next is vairagya, which we will learn in the coming episode. Until then, please stay tuned by subscribing to this channel. Your subscriptions will be a great help and encouragement. Also, please share it among your friends.